The Riviera Hotel in Las Vegas, the entertainment capital of the world. It's the Hollywood Squares with, from TV's Soap, Jay Johnson and Bob, Giles and Henderson. From Flamingo Road, Stella Stevens, Fred Willard, Jamie Lee Curtis, John Viner, Phyllis Diller, Dan Murray, and all in the Hollywood Squares. And here's the master of the Hollywood Squares, Peter Marshall.
Thank you, Kenny, and welcome once again to the Hollywood Squares. Hello, stars.
Hello, Peter.
Now, listen carefully, Paul. During the time of the hula hoop, yo-yos, and Davy Crockett hats, who was in the White House?
Oh, I'll say the yo-yo. It's a person who sits with one leg over the arm of a chair, likely to be cooperative or uncooperative.
Is this person a man or a woman?
When a man falls out of your boat and into the water, you should yell, "Man overboard." Now, what should you yell if a woman falls overboard?
Full speed ahead.
Hey, buddy, get a load of this. I've been working on my Paul Lynde impersonation. Yeah, listen to this. Well, they asked me one time why the butcher in the butcher's shop beats the meat. And I responded, "Oh, I don't know. Loneliness?" Yeah, listen to this one. Paul, in the nursery rhyme, Lady Bird, Fly Away Home, why should the ladybird fly home? Because Lyndon wants his chili. Yeah, dude, we gotta start a YouTube channel or something. I mean, God, I'm better than Rich Little. Hey, wait. Check this out. Who's this? I'm shaking the dust of this crummy little town off my feet, and I'm gonna see the world. Yeah, I got Jimmy Stewart down pretty good, don't I? Yeah, some people say it's my best impersonation. What is it you want, Mary? What do you want? You want the moon? Just say the word and I'll throw a lasso around it and I'll pull it down. Hey, that's a pretty good idea. I'll give you the moon, Mary. Yeah, I'm telling you. One of these days, we got to stop talking about it and just do it.
I don't know, like a podcast, a short film, online video, something.
I mean, I got to find a way to showcase my talent. Yeah, I know. We'll figure something out. Hey, are we still getting together to watch the game tonight? Okay. I'll see you then. Rock and roll.
Boy, they bring a football team.
We were doing Monday
night
football.
I fought many balls.
Good morning.
My diabetes was caused me stress.
Yeah, no.
Maybe we can get the
cow. You're always asking real rubber diabetes.
That's the way it is.
thank you for getting in touch with us. I'm Vincenzo, but you will call me Vinny. As you could probably tell from our detailed correspondence, our organization is looking for talented people to perform, shall I say, facsimiles of certain celebrities. It's very important you not waste our time. When we spoke on the phone, you were, to put it generously, very complimentary of your own talents.
Well, let me put it to you this way, Vinny. Rich Little, Frank Caliendo, Dana Carvey, morons. No talent hacks.
If you are the impersonator you say you are, then this will be a very short meeting. And I think you're going to find, you'll soon find yourself in a much, much higher tax bracket. Let's see what you got.
You want answers. You want answers. You can't handle the truth.
It's Roscoe P. Coltrane. You get the old Flash down there. I love it.
Oh, go get him, Rock. You gotta get back in the ring.
You can get yourself a square inch of Dollar Mountain for one measly dollar.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows?
Songs that made the hit parade!
One of the things that's so critically important about boulevards is making sure you don't go loosey-goosey on it for gras, where you can go loosey-goosey.
I mean, come on, that would have been unbelievable, right? You went undefeated on a coach nine! Who's the greatest coach of all time? Mike Krzyzewski. That was a trick question.
But a man worthwhile is one who can smile when he's shorts too tight in the seam.
King Lot, is that you?
I'm close. I can pull this fat cat down and bring him right off the hill.
People ask me, Mike, when I got my pillow, it sure helped out my neck. And I knew it would.
Those were the days.
Can you do a Jimmy Stewart?
Jimmy Stewart? Vinny? Jimmy Stewart's my specialty.
You sit around here and you spin your little webs and you think the whole world revolves around you and your money. Well, it doesn't, Mr. Potter.
That's good. That's very good. The ability to do Jimmy Stewart and do Jimmy Stewart, shall we say, very well. It's a significant and a key component to this position. This indeed was a short meeting. Congratulations, you got the gig. But first, a very minor housekeeping item. This brief contractual agreement. There's a lot of unimportant minutiae and standard disclosures. Just need a quick signature on that last page, and we can get you out quickly to your first assignment downtown.
Where in the devil is this place?
Are you the impersonator?
Well, I'm not Uncle Arthur from Bewitched.
Good. The boss has been waiting for you.
Jimmy Stewart better be good. I mean, your Jimmy Stewart better be real good.
Isn't it good? Merry Christmas, Holy Hall! Merry Christmas, Warrior!
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long time. I was round when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Me damn sure that
what we got to do is like head down there, like hang out in the outback and find ourselves like big old shrimp or something like that, put it on the barbie, fry that thing up, just do it delicate, do it really with a nice butter sauce or something like that.
Well, hoo-ah, looks like it's Serpico and Dog Day Afternoon all over again. Well, welcome home. No bastard ever won a war by dying for his country. He won it by making the other poor, dumb bastard die for his country.
Well, the country wants to know, honestly, if their president is a crook. Well, bottom line is, I'm not a crook. I've never been a crook since I was in school at Whittier College.
When I was in that movie, The Presidio, I'll never forget the scene where I said, "She's pouched like a minx." While the Wizard of Westwood drew up plays, I could smell colors, I could taste sounds, and I'm gonna be having fun with that senorita while you're back there behind them bars. Leonid Brezhnev, he is my uncle, but it does not put me in a situation such that Politburo will not elect me per se.
Cause I wear a silly grin.
She never comes late, no. She'd never bother with those people she'd hate, and that's why this chick is a tramp. Oh, Nelly, we've got ourselves a football game this afternoon. We're gonna be playing this ball game outdoors.
There's a watch, Butch, that your dad had this watch. He fought in Vietnam. He was in a hellhole over there. It was a terrible place. One of the things that I remember when I was sitting on the farm down there in Georgia, the first time I talked with Rosalind about the idea that a peanut farmer was gonna run for president of the United States. Wow, and Elton John was singing Philadelphia Freedom. Those are the days. So did Frank Gifford and so did Dandy Don, and boy, we could put away a couple of drinks when we were doing Monday Night Football. Good Lord, those were good days.
I knew that my diabetes was going to cause me distress and problem, but Deidre Hall was there, just like Liberty Mutual was there for me. God bless Liberty Mutual.
Oh, Bert, I was wondering if you can tell me a little bit about the bathtub and where my rubber ducky ended up.
Oh, Ernie, you're always asking where your rubber ducky is.
Well, that's because I can't find him. I love that little fella.
Apollo Creed's nothing compared to you, Rock. You can get him really good.